Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your teacher, Phyllaris Tirit. I'll be taking you through English Form 2, and today we're going to look at English Form 2, Lesson 3. Our topic will be grammar, and the subtopic we're going to look at the indefinite pronouns. So I expect that by the end of the lesson, a learner should be able to define an indefinite pronoun and describe the different types of indefinite pronouns. So when we talk of definite pronouns, we can say definite, these are pronouns which refer to people, places, or things in a general way. They do not have specifics. These indefinite pronouns are pronouns which refer to people, places, or things in a general way, and they do not have specifics. We have types of indefinite pronoun, those that can be followed by the preposition of. They are called the of indefinite pronoun, and we have the compound indefinite pronoun. When we talk of the of indefinite pronouns, they are followed by the of phrase, keyword of, indicating quantity. For example, I had to visit each of them. Each indicates quantity. And you can see that it comes before of. Most of my friends live abroad. Most still show the quantity. We also say the indefinite pronoun, sometimes the of phrase may be omitted if what is referred to is clear from the situation given. Example, after paying for the oranges, we discovered that some of them were rotten. So, some refers back to the oranges. Instead of repeating the same oranges, we can see the sentence as reads, after paying for the oranges, we discovered that some of them were rotten. That is when you omit the of with the word some, which refers back to the oranges that were being paid for. Another sentence, since Lucy likes both pork and mutton, you can offer either of them. Either refers back to the pork or mutton, and you can see the of has been omitted. Some suggest a positive amount. So we can look at those examples that suggest a positive amount, include the word all, any, several, none, neither, one, few, and much. Whereas any, none, and few suggest negative amounts. Now we can look at the compound indefinite pronouns, and we can say these are formed by combining two words. The compound indefinite pronouns can either refer to things or people. Example of the word some, every, and some. If you talk of someone as a person, everybody is a person. Something is not a person, but it refers to things. So when we say, we've just said compound indefinite pronouns can either refer to things or people. When you talk of something, it refers to a thing. Everybody, it refers to person. Someone refers to a person. We can also have those compound indefinite pronouns that refer to things. For example, everything. I need to know everything about your institution. Something. It's a thing. May I get something from that room? Nothing and anything all refer to the indefinite pronouns which refer to things. For example, if you look at nothing, I found nothing in that room. It was dark and we didn't see anything. And also, we can say the compound indefinite pronoun can refer to people, with words such as someone, somebody, someone, and nobody. Example, everybody. You can have it an example with the word everybody. The teacher taught everybody. You can use an example with the word anybody. They didn't find anybody in the field. You can also use the word everyone and say everyone has a role to play. And you can also use the indefinite pronoun anyone. And we say, with revision materials, anyone can pass exam. All compound indefinite pronouns are written as one except no one. All compound indefinite pronouns are written as one except no one. That's what like somebody, someone, something, they're all written as one word except the word no one. The following pairs of indefinite pronouns mean the same, although it is more common to use those that in one, to use those that end in one. Anyone and anybody. We mostly use anyone than anybody, everyone and everybody, someone and somebody, no one and nobody. Compound and indefinite pronouns beginning with aren't and no imply negative amounts. So those that imply negative amounts begins with aren't, A-N-T, that is aren't and no. Compound indefinite pronouns beginning with some suggest positive amounts. Those that suggest positive amounts begins with some. Having said that, you can try the assignment in the that goes fill in the blank spaces with the most appropriate indefinite pronoun. Try the questions. For much more on these indefinite pronouns, you can refer them to Excelling in English, Students Book 2, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. You can also reach us through our SMS line as posted, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter at Elimu TV_KE. Thank you for the lesson. Till next time.